Today is December 6th. It's the 341st day of the year, and this is the On This Day podcast. Born on this day in 1896, songwriter and lyricist Ira Gershwin. Together with his younger brother George Gershwin, Ira Gershwin writes some of the greatest and most memorable songs of the 20th century. Everybody loves George Gershwin, and he's a musical genius for sure. But it's his brother Ira who gives their songs meaning. George's music moves the listener, but Ira's words make the statement. They're writing songs of love, but not for me. If you can keep me, I want to stay here with you forever. Embrace me, my sweet, embraceable you. The Gershwin brothers are born Israel and Yaakov Gershowitz in New York City. Israel, born on this day in 1896, and Yaakov 2 years later in September 1898. Early on, their father changes the family name to Gershwin, which, when the boys become famous, becomes Gershwin. Ira loves Broadway shows, particularly those by the team of Gilbert and Sullivan. But he doesn't pursue music. Instead, he focuses on writing articles for the school paper. It isn't until 1921, when he's 24, that he begins writing songs for musical theater. By then, his brother George is beginning to make a name for himself as a songwriter. Hustlin' the music publishers along the legendary Tin Pan Alley, 28th Street in Manhattan. Ira writes his first songs under a pseudonym so as not to seem to be riding his brother's coattails. Later in 1921, Ira and George team up to write a touring musical, A Dangerous Mind. And then in 1924, Lady Be Good for Broadway. And with that show, it all takes off from there. The Gershwin brothers take Broadway by storm. They write a dozen musicals such as Funny Face, Showgirls, Porgy and Bess, and Strike Up the Band, as well as music for a half dozen films, including the Gene Kelly film An American in Paris. They're on top of their game until 1937 and George Gershwin's untimely death at the young age of 38. After George passes away, Ira retires from the music business. But after 3 years with no creative outlet, he returns to songwriting, pairing up with a few different composers such as Jerome Kern and Kurt Weill to write tunes for Broadway and the silver screen. None of the songs he writes in the latter part of his career are quite as powerful as those he writes with his brother, except perhaps for the songs he co-writes with Harold Arlen for the 1954 film A Star Is Born, starring Judy Garland. Throughout his career, Ira Gershwin is nominated for 3 Academy Awards. He never takes home an Oscar, but it's an honor just to be nominated. That's what they always say, right? Sure. Ira Gershwin, born on this day in 1896, passes away in 1983 at the age of 86. His music lives on in film and TV soundtracks. If you ever watch TV or go to the movies, you've heard Ira Gershwin songs on shows like The Man in the High Castle, Halt and Catch Fire, Transparent, movies like Avengers, Age of Ultron, numerous episodes of The Simpsons, The Walking Dead, The Sopranos, Gilmore Girls, The Aviator, and more than 500 other shows and movies over the past half century. And on the stage, currently, you can catch the touring production of An American in Paris. I saw it in Buffalo. It's fantastic. And it's got the best of the Gershwin brothers' music in it. All the songs you know and love. I Got Rhythm, Swonderful, Love Is Here to Stay, and But Not For Me, to mention just a few. But I'm partial to Porgy and Bess, particularly Nina Simone's rendition of I Loves You, Porgy. There are 25 days left in the year.
Let him handle me with his hot hands. If you can keep me, I wanna stay here with you forever. I've got my man.